Now, in this video, let us look at what is a degree sequence. The degree sequence of a graph is a sequence of degrees of the vertices of the graph in non-increasing order or non-decreasing order or non-decreasing order. Now, before we understand what is a degree sequence, then we need to understand what is the difference between the following terminologies. Number one is increasing order. Number two is non-decreasing order. Number three is decreasing order. And number four is non-increasing order. Now, what is the difference between all these four terminologies? Number one is the increasing order. Increasing order means all the values should be increasing, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, this is representing an increasing order and it is perfectly fine. And this is also representing a non-decreasing order. Okay, this is increasing order, correct? As well as this is non-decreasing order. But if you take an order something like this, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6. Now, this is not an increasing order, but yes, this is a non-decreasing order. This is a non-decreasing order. That means in a non-decreasing order or non-increasing order, the values can be duplicate. Duplicate values can be there, repeated values can be there. But in increasing order or in decreasing order, duplicate values cannot be there. For example, this is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, this is representing a decreasing order as well as it is also representing a non-increasing order. But if the value is like 5, 4, 3, 3, 2, 2, 1. Now, this is not representing a decreasing order, but rather it is representing a non-increasing order. So, here we are saying a degree sequence of a graph is a sequence of the degrees of the vertices of the graph in non-increasing order or non-decreasing order. Okay, so we are going to follow as non-increasing order. Okay, so now for example, let us find out the degree sequence of the following graphs. So here the degree of A is 1, degree of B is 1, degree of D is 1, degree of C is 1, and degree of E is 4. So what is the degree sequence for this? Degree sequence is 4, 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay, that is, we use a non-increasing order. Now for this figure, what is the degree of every vertex? For degree of A is 3, degree of E is 2, degree of D is 2, degree of C is 3, degree of B is 2. So what is the degree sequence here? There is 3, 3, 2, 2. So this is the degree sequence here. Okay, now let us look at the next diagram here. So next diagram is representing this. What is the degree sequence here? So this is representing degree 3, this is representing degree 4, this is representing degree 2, degree 2, degree 2, and this is representing degree 3. Okay, so for this graph, what is the degree sequence? There is 4, 3, 3, 2, 2, 2. So this is the degree sequence. Now look at this graph. Now what is the degree of A? It is 2. Degree of A is 2. Degree of E is 2. Degree of D is 2. It is 2. And here the degree is 4, and here the degree is 4. So what is the degree sequence? It is 4, 4, 2, 2, 2. So this is the degree sequence for this given graph. Now, what is the degree of A? 2. Degree of E? 3. Degree of F? 3. Degree of D? 3. Degree of C? 2. And this is the degree which is 3. So what is the degree sequence? The degree sequence is 3, 3, 3, 3, 2. So that will be the degree sequence for this given graph. Okay, now let us take some more examples here. Now find the degree sequence for the following graphs. The first graph is represented by K4. Now guys, we have already seen these graphs. Now let us look at these graphs one by one. When we say K4 is a complete graph with four vertices. It is representing the complete graph with four vertices. Okay, so what is a complete graph with four vertices? This is represented by this graph, vertex A, B, C, D, and we are going to have an edge between every two pair of vertices. So what is the degree of each vertex? The degree of this is 3, degree of this is 3, degree of this is 3, and degree of this is 3. So the degree sequence will be 3, 3, 3, 3. Now the next graph is represented by C4. Now C4 means it is representing a cycle with 4 vertices. So this is A, B, C, and D. So for this graph, the degree sequence will be 2, 2, 2, 2. So this is the cycle. Now the third one is representing W4. W4 means it is wheel with 4 vertices. Okay, so this is a wheel with 4 vertices. Okay, now for this, what is the degrees of each vertex? The degree of all these 4 vertices is 3, 3, 3, and 3. But the degree of this vertex is 4. So the degree sequence will be 4, 3, 3, 3. Now the next is K22. K2, 3. 2, 3, that means it is a complete graph, complete bipartite graph. It is a complete bipartite graph. Bipartite graph. So how does this graph look? It means that we are having 2 vertices here. It may be A and B, and we may be having 3 vertices here, which is C, D, and E. So it will look something like this. This is a complete bipartite graph. Now what is the degree of this? It is 3. The degree of this is 3. This is a degree of 2. This is a degree of 2. This is a degree of 2. So the degree sequence is 3, 3, 3. 3, 3, 2, 2, 2. Okay. Now, next is Q3. Q3 means it is representing a cube. So we have Q3. So Q3 means this is representing Q3. Okay. So this is representing Q3. Now for this Q3, the degree of every vertex here, this is the degree which is 3, its degree is 3, its degree is 3, its degree is 3, degree is 3, degree is 3, degree is 3, and degree is 3. So degree of every vertex is 3. So how many 3's are there? For every edge we have a degree. So for every vertex we have a degree. So how many vertices are there? There are a total of 8 vertices, which is 2 raised to power 3, total of 8 vertices. So we have 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. Okay, so this is the degree of each vertex. Now see guys, you need to make sure that in case of complete graph, the degree of vertex, every vertex will be exactly the same. So if we have 4 vertices, then degree of all these 4 vertices will be same, and as well as the degree of every vertex will be n minus 1. If there are n vertices, then n minus 1, n minus 1, n minus 1, n minus 1, up to so on n times. Okay, now if we discuss about this complete graph, this is Q3. Now here again the degree will be the same for all the vertices. For example, if it is Q3, then there will be 2 raised to power 3 vertices, so degree of every vertex will be 3. Okay, in the same way you can discuss something about this also, because it is K2, 3. So these 2 vertices will be having a degree which is 3, and these vertices will be having a degree which is 2. So if we have KM, N, that means for this M vertices the degree will be N, and for this N vertices the degree will be M. So if M is greater than N, so you can find out what will be the degree sequence for this. In the same way you can find out a pattern for the degree sequence for the wheel, in the same way you can find out the pattern for the degree sequence for the cycle. So you can answer the following question: what is the degree sequence of a bipartite graph KM, N? That we already answered, where M, N are positive integers. We can explain our answer. Next is, what is the degree sequence of KN, that complete graph with N vertices, where N is a positive integer. We have already done this one. Then how many edges does a graph have if the degree sequence is this? Now this is important. Okay, so they are saying, how many edges does this graph have if the degree sequence is 4, 3, 3, 2, 2. For this we have to find out whether the graph does exist or not. So to see whether there is a graph that does exist, or if it is graphic, for this we have a theorem which is called as Havel Hakimi procedure, or you can say Havel Hakimi theorem, or you can say algorithm. Havel Hakimi algorithm. Okay, so in this video we just had a discussion about what is the degree sequence. Now for these given two questions, there is this question and this question, we can easily find out the graph for this, because they are not asking whether the graph exists or not. They are just saying how many edges the following graph have if the decay sequence is given by this. Now guys, it is a very simple procedure here, because we have already seen the tricks about this, that the sum of degree of all vertices, the sum of degree of all vertices in a graph will be equivalent to 2 into number of edges in the graph, correct? This is the first thing that we have seen in our today's lecture. So the sum of degree of all vertices, that is 4, 3, 3, 2, 2. Now we are not checking whether graph exists or not, okay? We are not checking at all. So we are just checking what would be the number of edges. Now the number of edges here is 4 + 3 + 3 + 2 + 2. So here the sum should be 4 + 6, this 4 + 6 + 4, which is representing 14. So in total we are going to have 7 edges in this particular graph. In the same way, we can find out what is the number of edges for this graph. Now after finding the number of edges, we can draw such kind of graph. But for that, before we draw this graph, let us first discuss about the Havel Hakimi procedure. What does this Havel Hakimi procedure says, and then we'll try to draw these graphs in our example. Okay.